Here we come with the brainstorming, and the first question is we have to explain the meaning of the following words. So humility means freedom from pride. Second is self-esteem, that is self-confidence, confidence of oneself. Gratitude means thankfulness, courtesy, respect, generosity, big-heartedness, sympathy, compassion, pity, empathy, experiencing the feelings of others. Now there is a next question. Group discussion topic is given. Whether the need of soft skills at workplace is necessary, the need of soft skills. Soft skills, that is the speaking abilities. So is it necessary? Yes or no? We have to take written and verbal communication, ways of interacting with others, creative ability, emotional intelligence. All these points we can consider, and we can write, we can do a group discussion on this topic. Coming to activity 2, text, read the text and say whether the following statements are true or false. First one is, bitter problems in day-to-day life can be solved by sweet words. Is it true? Yes. Great wars could have been avoided by little courtesy. True. Observance of etiquettes in normal situation is important, but more important is their observance with the situation if adverse. It is again true. Words like please and thank you help us in making our passage through life uneasy. No, it's true. Then the law permits anybody to use violence if another person is discourteous. No, it doesn't. It does not permit. You have to write that the false statement is to be corrected. Now, what is the theme of the essay? The theme of the essay tells us about the courtesy, civility, morality, responsibility, and control over our feelings. The essay also explores the difficulties that can be incurred if individual dealing with the public. Now, one can keep one's peace of mind without having to lower themselves to the level of perceived offender, that is, we are offended. People with low self-esteem are generally difficult to work with, and they look down upon others to get the feeling of superiority. So all these are the theme of the essay. Next is, what is the reason of liftsman's uncivilized behavior? So the passenger refused to say top please to the liftman. So his refusal hurt him acutely, and that damaged his social standing, that is social behavior. This is the answer for this question. Now list the people and their behavior that made the passengers rude and ill-mannered. So all these people have hurted him one by one. It is a cycle. Housemate, wife, husband, employer, liftman and passenger. So all these people, it is there. Good manners are required in our daily life for making our social context more cooperative and friendly. Illustrate the behavior of polite conductor with different people in different situations. All these are given you in the slide. You can see, go through it and understand. Answers for certain questions I have given you here. Discuss and write the impact for good tempered and kindliness in the society in the light of good mannered conductor's behavior. I have given you that answer. The next question, you have to do it yourself. Explain the statement with the examples. The service of a police is necessary for implementation of laws in our society. Do you think you require the service of good social environment? Yes, you can write, you can discuss and write, so you can understand that whether for having a good social environment, you also need certain people to keep a watch on it or not. You can mention it that and write. Next is co-location words are given there that come together and have a different meaning, like it is given strong tea or fast train. These two are the, we do not say it rich tea, we say it strong tea. Or that actually the tea is not strong. In the same way, the train comes quickly, but we do not say it quick quick train, we say it fast train. So these words that come together are called co-location words, and we have to pair it in from column A to column B. So regular, I have given you the answers for that. You can go through it. Here we have some co-location words using the prefix of big and well. Big mistake, big surprise, big failure, well known, well designed, well wisher, and so on. You can go through these words and understand the co-location words. Now in this slide we can see that we have to change the word class, that is the form of the word. We have to change it from the noun to verb or adjective or adverb, and we have to, as the sentence demands, and then we have to write that sentence. Like, I ask Sumit to my pencil for me. So to sharpen my pencil for me, here the word sharpen is added. Now for crunchy apple, instead of we writing crunch apple, we can write it crunchy apple. Looks color, picture looks color, instead of that we have to write colorful picture. So as the sentence demands, whether it noun is needed or verb is needed, adverb is needed, adjective is needed, we have to make the changes. We have to change the class of the word, and then we have to write, that is word class we have to change. So I am afraid that your behavior is just not acceptable. Just not accept, we cannot write acceptable. I like my elder brother. He is very helpful, not help. So given below is the table. See the changes and see the words and make the changes accordingly. Write all the forms of the verb. Go through it. Now in this slide we come across the word register. It doesn't mean the writing register. It means register, that is a hard to take a notice of and do a certain formality. As we see someone in the morning, what kind of gesture will be yours? So you are going to say good morning, or while we are going apart, we can say goodbye. So in this way we are going to show our gestures. That is known as register, often refers to a degree of formality of a language, but it should be different for different people. When you come across a principal or a teacher, you are not supposed to say hey dude or what's up. You are going to say to them good morning sir, good morning ma'am. In this way the gestures will be different for different people, whereas to your friends you are not going to say good morning sir or ma'am. You are going, definitely you are going to say hey dude or WhatsApp. So it depends, the degree of formality of language depends on the person on whom you are interacting with. So likewise, while writing a letter of complaint, what are the proper expressions that you will write? You have to mention it in this question. Now in this lesson we have learned a lot about manners and behavior. So the if somebody fails to show the manners, is that behavior punishable? So whatever is punishable, that is a legal offense, and whatever is not punishable by law, it is not an legal offense. So let us see what burglary, that is to steal, assault and battery, to treat anyone with bad behavior, to box people's ears, kick on the shins, all these are the gestures which are violent, so they are legal offenses. Whereas rude behavior, or to wound somebody's self-respect, or to hurt somebody's feelings and emotions, moral and intellectual damage, all these are moral offenses that are not much actionable, and only the materialistic things are legal offense. That is shown difference between legal offense and moral offense, to hurt someone morally. go through the questions, find the meanings of the phrases that are given. You can refer dictionary or you can refer books and find the meaning of these phrases. Prefix, meaning of prefix, already you know suffix that comes afterwards. Prefix, the words that come before, like un, dis, in, all these words are coming in the prefix. Meant, shun, all these words come in the suffix, the words are given. So these are the words that we see it in the textbook that are given to you. Now the last one, we have learned a lot about manners, moral manners in this lesson. What are the do's and the don'ts in this table? It is given. If you want, for example, see children, I want a cup of tea. You can write it. You can say it in the polite way. I would like to have a cup of tea. Your work isn't good. Don't hurt anybody. Just say, I'm afraid your work isn't good. Send me the mail. Don't order anyone. Just say, send me the mail, please. Use the word please. Go away or leave me alone. So you can say it, please go away. Could you leave me alone? You can ask in a question form. You are wrong. Instead of saying that, you just say, I'm afraid you are wrong. That's a bad idea. So thanks for the idea, but it's bad. In a gentle way, the author tries to say here that though you want to give a negative reply, you have to be polite and humble without hurting the feelings of the person in front of you. Use of articles is to be given here. What is to be used, what is not to be used, you have to write it, and you have to, it is already given to you, you just take a note of it. Spot the errors. This is one more important question. This time it is a new question for you in the syllabus. Go through it properly. You have to find out what are the wrong things in that sentence and write it. Like first sentence, Radha bought pens and distributed them between her five children. Now, as the number of children is five, you cannot say between. Between comes only for two things. So, among her five children, Jayashree and Sujata sat beside each other in complete silence. So, besides, instead of besides, beside each other. S is not required. His best friend Vijay was blind within one eye. So with one eye, not within, not inside the eye. One could dare to encroach on his rights. One could dare to encroach on rights. So right word his, not necessary. She was taken with surprise when she saw the famous Taj Mahal. With, not with, by surprise. It is not possible to exchange the goods once the sale has been completed. Exchange, you cannot say exchange, return. Exchange is possible, return is not possible. Dr. Sen Gupta has been trying, so has tried to master the craft for 5 years. It is definite, time is given, so it is a perfect tense. So has tried. The top ranking candidates will be appointed two senior jobs in banks. She knows very well what is expected from her, but she is unable to perform. Yet she is unable to perform. But instead of but, it will be yet, because she knows it already. They will put on a note in the regard for your consideration. So you are going to write, they will put down a note in the regard for your consideration. Take a note of these changes and write it in your notebook. Now in this slide, we need to read the instructions from the manual and we have to follow it. That is given in this particular question. Read the following sentences. Santosh purchased a computer. He read the following operating manual and followed the instructions. So one by one we have to read it and just follow it. That is for the reading practice. Next question is, convert these sentences into passive voice by filling the blanks. The answers are given in the brackets. What we have to do, we have to change the voice of that sentence from active voice to passive voice. Firstly, the monitor, keyboard, and the printer were linked up. Then the main cable was plugged in. Like that, the answers are given. You can the same thing is from active voice, we have changed it into passive voice, and the conversion is done. This activity 5 is a speech writing. You have to write a speech on courtesy is the light of life. So with the help of the following points, you have to write. You have to make a note of the people who have a good impression on you, good impression of you. You have to acknowledge and appreciate them all. You have to be happier and contented in life. You don't have to curse or blame others for you not being successful. In this way, be courteous to the people in your life. That is the main content you have to write in the speech. Now, manners maketh man. Means manners make man. You have to expand this idea and write this properly in your notebook, in your own words. Now, soft skills are required. And what are soft skills? These the what is the ability, presentation skills, networking abilities, etiquettes, awareness, all these are important things in our life. These are known as soft skills. These we all should know when we live in a social life. So they are important. That is just a information for you. It's a question of a web diagram. You have to write the points related to discourtesy. You can say that discourtesy is more spreading like epidemics. No legal system is against discourtesy. It poisons the stream of general life. Not regarded as punishable offense. It does not exclude violent attack. It is not a legal offense and no penalty by law for discourtesy. No legal system is against it. And you can give the examples that you have seen in the lesson. The housemaid answered the cook back. The cook behaved rude with the house owner. Then she behaved rudely with her husband. In turn, he didn't say good morning to his employee, and the employee also was infected with discourtesy and didn't say top please to the lift man, and the lift man got irritated and threw the passenger. So all are interconnected. Manners are very necessary to live life smoothly in the social society. So it is important. The importance of manners is shown by the writer in this lesson. That is the main theme of this lesson, which we need to understand. Thanks for watching. Meet you in the next part. Till then, goodbye.
So friends, don't forget to subscribe the channel and share the video, and also to like the video. Thanks for watching.